Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. In this video, I'm gonna share with you Sunday special lunch recipe. Every time we have a rain here or the weather is cold out there, I always crave for spicy food. This weekend was the same case, so I thought let me make chole bhature. I know I have shared many times chole recipe before, but the one that I'm sharing today will make everything from scratch. So all masalas and everything I'm making from scratch, as well as I'm sharing bhature recipe, which I have never shared on my channel before. If you make bhatura this way, it will come out so soft. Even if you eat it next day, it will just melt in your mouth. Also, I'm sharing very first time lakhi halwa recipe. Diwali is coming, so of course you can make this if you have a guest coming for lunch, or even you can make this recipe for dinner also, and it doesn't require that much pre-preparation, or it doesn't even require that much time also. So let's go ahead and start. I'll share with you all this recipe again, all three recipe I'm sharing very first time on my channel. So without further ado, let's go ahead and start. So let's start making halwa first. For that, I do have this lakhi. I'm gonna peel the skin first. After peeling skin, you do want to try a little bit. Make sure it's not bitter, otherwise by the time you are done making halwa, it's not gonna taste good at all. And then I'm gonna grate it. After grating it, I'm gonna transfer that into this hot pan. At this point, I'm not adding any ghee at all, but I'm gonna add 1 cup of milk. Mix everything, cover that for about 5 to 7 minutes on a medium flame, and then you still want to keep stirring it every minute or so. Make sure it doesn't stick to the bottom. Once the milk is completely absorbed, I'm gonna add 1 cup of sugar in there. Once you add the sugar, again it is gonna ooze out some water, but no worries, just keep stirring it. And then I'm gonna add the dry nuts. You can add any kind of nuts you like. I have a cashew and almond. I roughly chop both of them and then add that into it. And then I'm gonna add the mawa in there. So basically this is 12 ounces of mawa. I cut it in the half, so it's about 6 ounces, and roughly chop that and then add that into the lakhi. Keep mixing it really well. Temperature has to be on very low flame. And then that's it. Our lakhi halwa, it's all done. As you saw, doesn't take that much time. And at this point, guys, if you want to add the green color into it, you can go ahead and add it. I'm not a big fan of those colors and everything, so I'm not adding anything. But if you are making for, you know, party or guest coming, you can go ahead and add that. No big deal. But I was just making for only for us, so did not add any color into it. So that's it. Lakhi halwa, it's all done. So let's make the atta for bhatura. For that, I do have 2 cups of all-purpose flour, that is the maida, 1 cup of yogurt, 1 tablespoon oil, and salt to taste. I thought it was recording, but somehow I missed that part. But that is the measurement I use. And first of all, you do want to mix everything with the yogurt. And then only if you need water, you do want to add water little by little, and you do want to use the warm water. Consistency of this atta should be like paratha atta, not like chapati. So we don't want very soft dough. That's the reason when you add water, you have to be very careful with this. And then after that, I'm going to cover this for about 15 to 20 minutes. So while dough is resting, we're going to go ahead and make the chole. So for that, I do have tablespoon ghee and tablespoon oil. Combination of both this tastes really good. And then I'm going to add chopped onion into this. Let that cook for about 2 minutes until it's translucent, and then add chopped garlic and grated ginger. If you want, you can always add ginger garlic paste into this, and that's fine too. After mixing it everything very well, I'm going to add fire roasted tomato. If you don't have this kind of one, you can always use regular chopped tomato. The reason I'm using this, so it gives that roasted flavor into this, but regular tomato is fine too. I'm going to let this cook, and then on the other side, we're going to go ahead and make masala. So for that, I do have cumin seeds, whole red chili, peppercorn, cinnamon steak and just a 2 or 3 methi dana. Also, I do have 1 bay leaf. So I'm gonna dry roast everything first. Once it's roasted, I'm gonna transfer that into the coffee grinder and make the powder out of it. Other side, I'm gonna add red chili powder, dhaniya jeera powder, haldi powder, as well as the masala that we made. And believe me guys, when you have your own fresh masala, entire kitchen smells so good, and of course chole came out so tasty. After mixing it, I'm gonna add water also in this just so the masala doesn't get burned. I'm gonna let that simmer for another 5 to 7 minutes, and on the other side I'm gonna dry roast kasuri methi. This is totally optional. If you don't want to do it, you don't have to, but I'm just gonna go ahead and dry roast it for about a minute or so. I'm gonna add salt to taste into the gravy as well as the kasuri methi, and then I'm gonna add chole to this gravy. Chole, rajma, all these things, the more you let them simmer, taste really good. So at this point, I'm gonna add water into this, cover that, and let that simmer for another 10 to 15 minutes. And believe me guys, this chole came out so perfect. So last but not the least, let's go ahead and make the bhatura. So at this point, dough was resting for about half an hour. I'm gonna go ahead and roll it, and shape wise you can have it however you like it. You can have them in round shape, oval shape, but just make sure that it is even out from all the side. And after that, that's it. I'm gonna go ahead and deep fry them. So friends, this is it. If you follow this exact recipe, I'm sure your bhatura will be exactly same like mine. As you can see here, they do fluff up, they taste good, and the best part about them is even if you eat them next day, they will be so soft. Because if you're familiar with the maida, you know that if you keep it for even about half an hour, it's really hard to make them apart. But with this recipe, you will not have that problem at all. So as you can see here, they are fluffy, they are so soft. So do try this recipe and let me know guys, because you know, whoever tried at my house this bhatura, they all loved it. So I was like, let me share with you guys. So this is it. This is my Sunday special lunch. I made rice as well as this chole. Came out so good, guys. So who say that you need store-bought masala to make the things yummy, right? And yes, by the time we ate lunch, half of the lakki halwa was finished. And then this is my tandoori onion as well as yogurt. So this is it friends. I hope you guys have enjoyed today's video. Thank you so much for watching. Take care, and I will see you guys soon in my next video. Bye.